Hi, my name is Brian Ansbach, and along with Josh Stevens, Kyle Duffield, Ryan Benoy, and Devin McMahon, we make up Design Team 31. As a group, we were tasked with designing a plant that would take C4s from ethylene production and make styrene out of them. The conversion to styrene occurs through two reactions. The first reaction converts butadiene in the mixed C4s into VCHX. Cyclooctane is also created in this reaction in small amounts. Next, the VCHX is sent to a second reactor in which the styrene is produced. In this reactor as well, byproducts are produced such as ethylbenzene, benzoic acid, and benzaldehyde. Using this process, our goal was to design a styrene facility in an existing plant that would produce 630 million pounds of styrene each year, or approximately 75,000 pounds per hour. We were also challenged with producing styrene at 99.9% purity. Two options were available for the location of the plant. The first option was Taiwan. A Taiwan plant has an advantage in that the mixed C4s feed comes directly from an existing plant next to it. And it also, in Asia, the styrene market is larger. The second option is a Gulf Coast plant. A Gulf Coast plant could be constructed with a 10% discount on capital cost. After careful consideration and taking into account each aspect, we decided that a plant in Taiwan would be the best option. Our reason for deciding this was the fact that the C4 feed was right in the plant, as well as the larger market. A Gulf Coast plant would have required shipping, which would have boosted the expenses and decreased the profit of the plant. The Taiwan plant produced styrene at a purity of 99.9118% and also met the yearly production goals. The product also needed to stay below certain PPM limits of components. Ethylbenzene needed to stay below 500 parts per million, total olefins below 1,000 parts per million, oxygenates and water below 100 parts per million. As can be seen in the data, all of these specs were met, as cyclooctane was the only contaminant present in the product. Styrene and VCHX loss also needed to stay below 2% goals. The styrene loss was approximately 1.185%, and the VCHX loss was 0.369%. These specs also meet the design goals. Another goal was the selectivity of butadiene to styrene, which needed to meet 78%. This spec was met as well. Waste from the plant was sent to multiple options. A flare was used for the gases, and liquid waste streams were sent to the proper disposal, to proper treatment, and then disposed of properly. Water was sent to sewage treatment plant, as the only contaminant present was CO2. The overall design process consisted of a VCHX reactor, an oxydehydrate reactor, four distillation columns, and a settler. Josh will now discuss the block flow diagram and go into more detail about the process.
Hello, my name is Josh, and I'm going to give an overview of the block flow diagram of our process. It begins with the C4 feed mixing with the butadiene recycle stream in a mixing tank. It is then fed to the VCHX reactor, which converts the butadiene into VCHX. From there, the VCHX is purified from the C4s in a distillation column, in which the C4s go to a recycle stream where butadiene is separated out and recycled, and the raffinate is sold as fuel. The pure VCHX stream goes to a mixing tank to be mixed with a VCH recycle from the end of the process. The mixture then goes to another mixing tank where it's mixed with an oxygen feed and then sent to the oxydehydrate reactor, where VCHX and oxygen are converted into our product styrene, as well as three other undesirable side products which need to be separated out. The effluent goes to a three-phase separator where it then splits into water, gases, and organics. The gases, which contain oxygen, CO2, and other traces, are then sent to a flare. The water is mixed with fresh steam stream and sent back into the oxydehydrate reactor. The organic stream, containing all the other elements, is sent into our separation process. First, the organics are separated into lights and heavies. From there, the lights go to the second separator, which separates out the VCHX and the other light components. And from here, the VCHX is recycled back into the VCH reactor, and the lights are sent to the waste tank. The heavies go to a final separator, which then separates our final product, styrene, from the heavy organics. Styrene in its final form is then sent to our storage, and the heavies are also sent to the waste. So Kyle is going to talk about the economics of our process. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Kyle, and I'll be talking about some of the economics of our process today. First off, capital costs. Total IBL capital costs, including all types of equipment inside the factory, is about $170 million. Total OBL capital costs, including everything outside the process equipment, is $62 million. Factored into the capital cost is a backup unit for every pump and compressor, and these have the exact same specifications as their counterpart. Contingency, which accounts for unforeseen issues in the future, such as malfunctions and breakdowns, is estimated to be 20% of the total capital cost. Racks and sewage for drainage and disposal are estimated to be 20% of the total capital cost. The lights heavy separator was a large part of the capital because it's a very difficult separation and requires a very high reflux ratio, which was 60, and a very large tower height, which was 173 feet. A different type of separator, perhaps a liquid extractor, could do the separation at a lower capital cost. The lights heavy's top stream compressor was also a very costly component because it's compressing vapor from a near vacuum to 75 psi, and this could potentially be solved by splitting it into a two-stage compressor. The VCHX heavy separator was also a very costly component for the same reason as the other separator, and that too could probably be solved by a liquid extractor. Finally, the VCHX recycle mixing tank was a very costly component because of its 8-hour residence time. It could potentially be broken down into smaller units, but that might actually be a higher capital cost. Another big component of the economics of the process was operating costs. These are broken down into raw materials, fixed costs, and utilities. Raw materials included the C4 feedstock, steam, oxygen, catalyst, inhibitor, and other miscellaneous chemicals, individual prices of which will be discussed in the next slide. Fixed costs included labor. We estimated 15 laborers with a combined salary and benefits of $85,000 a year. It also included overhead, which was estimated at 1.5 times the cost of labor. It included repair and maintenance, estimated at 1.5% of the total capital cost. It included insurance, estimated at 0.5% of the capital cost. And then included property tax, estimated at 1.5% of the capital cost. Utilities included refrigerant, cooling water, low pressure, medium and high pressure steam, oil, and electrical power. The individual prices of these are pictured in the table here. The byproducts, which generated income, included the C4 raffinate that is separated from butadiene in the butadiene recycle stream. Inflation or escalation accounts for a 3% increase in costs each year. SG&A stands for selling, generation, and administration. Selling includes advertising, rent, sales tax, and other selling costs. Administration includes executive salaries and general support costs. And generation includes any other costs that don't fit into any of the previous categories. This puts a 2% addition to yearly operating costs. Total operating costs for the facility are $230 million per year. The chart picture plots a 20-year trend of all the raw materials and product involved in this process. As you can see, the price of styrene is steadily rising and should be profitable in the near future.
Hi, my name is Ryan Benoit, and I'm about to go over the economic evaluation done for the styrene plant. For the base case, we found that the required netback to gain 20% ATROR was 49.16 cents per pound of styrene. Our projected was that styrene would be 49.19 cents per pound, and this would yield an ATRO of 20.52%, higher than the required. And then the net present worth would be $189.1 million, again, higher than the $30 million that was required for the process, and a cumulative cash flow of $533 million. For the economic analysis, we did multiple sensitivity studies. The first was we altered the price of styrene. When we showed that the price of styrene decreased, if with a 2% decrease, the ATRO would drop below 20%. If the price decreased by 11.5%, then we would drop below the net present worth of $30 million, which was again required for the process. On the other hand, if the styrene price increased by 10%, we'd reach an ATRO of 26.53 and a net present worth of $326.6 million, which would be much higher than what was originally necessary to go on with the process. Again, we altered the C4's feed coming into the process. If the process dropped 3%, then we would again go below the ATRO of 20%. A 16.5% increase in price of the C4's feed showed that the price would drop to a net present worth of $30 million. And on the other hand, again, a 10% increase of price decreased the ATRO to 15.61% and a net present worth of $96.7 million. And then if C4's feed then decreased by 10%, we'd begin making more money as expected, reaching an ATRO of 24.79% and a net present worth of $283.9 million. This kind of just shows that even with the fluctuation of the price of C4's coming into the plant, going from a 10% increase or 10% decrease, the plant will always remain profitable. The ATRO value will go up and down a little below the 20%, but we'd always be above the net present worth. Again, we altered the price of oil, and in this sensitivity study, everything was based off of the price of oil. So the incoming feed prices and the product prices were all based off of the price of oil, based off of correlations that were done, and also the utilities. So currently, the price of oil was assumed to be around $55 per barrel. And so if oil increased to 62, this would cause the ATRO to drop below the 20%. That is a 9.4% increase in the price of oil that we used for our sensitivity study. If it increased to 130 million, which is a lot higher than it's ever been in the past 20 years, then our net present worth would fall below 30 million. So that just kind of shows that the net present worth, if everything is based off of the price of oil, will always be positive. And currently, the price of oil in 2016 was based off as $43 per barrel. And so this shows an ATRO of roughly 22% and a net present worth of $220 million, which again would allow the project to go forward. Another sensitivity study that was done was altering the price of natural gas. This sensitivity study was done because this affected all the utilities. So the cold water streams, the high pressure steam, middle pressure stream, and the low pressure streams. Again, if natural gas increased to $6.30 per barrel, the ATRO would fall below 20%, which is a 4.7 increase. And it would take natural gas to increase to $11.5 per barrel for the net present worth to drop below 30 million. So the price of utilities does make a big difference in the plant. And then the final sensitivity study that was done was altering the capital cost to see how that would affect the net present worth and the ATRO. A 3% increase in capital cost would drop the ATRO to 20%. And it would take an 85% increase in capital to make the net present worth value to 30 million, but this would also decrease the ATRO to 10%, roughly, which is a very unacceptable number. And a 15% decrease in capital costs obviously increases the ATRO and net present worth to 23.56% and 217.2 million, respectively.
Hi, I'm Devin McMahon, and I'm going to go over the conclusion. So, in conclusion, the required net back between the C4 raffinate and styrene sales is 49.16 pounds of styrene, cents per pound of styrene to meet the 20% ATROR. Our projections show we will make at least 49.19 cents per pound of styrene for a 20.52% ATROR. The net present value of the company is $189.1 million. Some of our recommendations are to look into the possibility of selling the ethyl benzene as a side product, which could eventually make us more money and give us more room for fluctuation in feed prices. The plant needs to be operational in about 3 years. Any longer, and the minimum ATROR of 20% will not be reached. We need to study and monitor the prices of C4 and styrene, as even minute changes in unit prices could drastically drop the ATROR. Capital cost of the building the plant has to be confirmed, because a 3% increase in capital cost is enough to drop below the 20% ATROR evaluation. And then finally, we have to evaluate the styrene market to ensure it has room for the plant's capacity. For example, if only 93% can be sold, the ATROR will drop down to 16%. Thank you, and this concludes our presentation.